Well, the first thing, we handled it properly. I don't know if it was because of our moral issues or whether we fear these kind of questions when we finish the film. So, what we did was, we started by contacting the community leaders and telling them we wanted to do a film about an issue, a historical issue that was very much their own. We presented the story, we went to Bolivia, met with them, told them what we wanted to do, and then they said, well, this is not a decision we take, this has to be taken by each of us. So come back next Sunday. We were meeting at a football court where they meet every Sunday. And come back next Sunday because we're going to discuss it among ourselves. So they got everybody involved. They discussed their different issues they had to deal with, whether it was water issues or housing or whatever it was. And as a last point in their schedule, it was the film. So they decided it was a good thing for them and that they wanted to participate. They let us know. And what we did was we structured a way where we would pay each extra that was coming into the film an amount that was, I think it was $20 a day, which is not a huge amount, but it's certainly more than in the film and certainly more than what they were making in their own jobs. And then each community leader was responsible for bringing from their own neighborhood whichever amount of people we needed. So each neighborhood, let's say there were 17 different barrios, and each of them brought about 300 people. So they were responsible for making sure that each family within the neighborhood had the chance to participate. And then if they had, for example, brought 300, they were entitled to something else that was going to the community, not just to the people who came to work in the film. And we didn't want to do it in cash, so basically they said, look, we need very diverse kinds of things. Some people said, we need 2,000 bricks to finish off a school that we're building. Other people asked for some basket hoops. Other people wanted computers, so there were, and in that way, each individual who worked in the film had a remuneration, but also their community they came from, and it worked extremely well. So, thank you. The shooting was 9 weeks, and we were preparing the film with the full crew for 3 months before that, and the casting and the location scout, we started about 8 months before we actually shot. So, and then the post-production, 6 months. So we shot it in October, November, December of 2009. It was 5 million euros, which is about $6.5-7 million.
Wow.
How about over here? Yes.
Did you document the making of your film?
Yes, there is a making of that we have, absolutely. The film is actually going to be released on February 18th here in the US. So, thank you. So there will be, I'm sure, in the website, the making of, and so if you want to see it. Evo Morales at the time was fighting the water war. And everybody say the water war in Cochabamba was the start of the change in Bolivia because it was the beginning of Evo's, who was for all his life he had been a working class leader. It was the beginning of his notoriety and his rise as the opposition leader. So, but I think he was chosen president 4 or 5 years after the water wars.
Yeah, do you want to go? So the question is, how did you get this, basically, how did you manage to getting the support of the Spanish government, the Bolivian government, in spite of the fact that you're pointing out some of the not so great things that they have been involved in?
Yes. I think there's a certain irony of and coolness about accepting what we did wrong 500 years ago and participating in films or whichever other communication means that state that. You seem to be progressive, you seem to be accepting of your own errors. So the 15th century part was not an issue. When it came to actually trying to raise private money from multinational companies in Spain to support this film, that was another issue. So we funded the film through, you know, the commercial means, normal commercial means, from broadcast money, distributors, some subsidy money, co-production, and so. But the last 3 months, I've been trying to find multinational companies in Spain that will only, not even with money, but they will just participate in the debate about the role of Spanish companies in Latin America today, and no one wanted to participate. Thank you so much.